When you're excavating for the pole base units, you can do it a couple of different ways. Probably the preferred way is an auger that would drill a hole in the earth. We're using an excavator today. Well, once they get the hole dug, they'll want to run the compactor in there and then put crushed stone in the bottom and compact that. About 6 inches is what we're looking for. That gives the pole base a good base to set on so it isn't going to move. Well, the best way to set the pole base in the hole is to use a lifting plate. And we actually manufacture a plate that has a swivel hoop on top, but it bolts down to the four anchor bolts that are sticking out of the pole base. And then the excavator here will hook onto that and then set the pole into the hole. The next thing you do is make sure the pole is in the right spot. You also need to make sure that pole base is level and it's not leaning one way or the other. And then you start backfilling in lifts, about 6-inch lifts. Typically it's crushed stone, sometimes it's the native sandy soil. You don't want to use a clay or topsoil or anything that won't compact well or doesn't drain well. So you're backfilling up the base of your hole around your pole base, and then you get to about the point where the electrical conduits plug into the side of the pole base. You kind of stop backfilling at that point so you can put the conduits in, you can put another 6 inches of sand and compact right over top of the conduit. So after you're done backfilling around the pole base and you've got it all compacted up to the top, you can really finish around the pole base however you want. You could pave up to it. You could also put landscape around there, a little topsoil, however you want to finish around the pole base to make it look a little bit better.